We are going to start very simple, and of course I will be looking myself by the previous work, because when I work on the set, once I finish one image, I use this as a reference. I'm looking for the perfect look for one image, what I want to achieve, and then this image is the reference for me. So the first step that I'm going to apply into this other image will be working with color balance, which I did over here with the name T, just straight after contrast. And as you can see, the contrast were actually different here. So you apply sort of same steps or similar steps with different results. So have a look what I did over here. I'm not sure it will not be seen, but for sure, let's turn off most of the things. So we will see what we have here. Okay. So you can see I wasn't really happy with the shadows and highlights I already had here. So I went even more into purple colors, because of course that was the main idea. So I get quite harsh, a lot of magenta and a lot of blues. So purples, magenta, blues, it's somewhere in between, most in the magenta direction. So the key is the image is not exactly the same looking at this stage. So what we have to do, of course, colors balance and color. I'm going to put the T as a tones, and let's go with shadows. I'm going to add a little bit blues. I'm going to stick with 5 as it was before. And as you can see, if I put the same values, it actually doesn't match, because on this image, it's a little stronger. So for sure, I would have to just get it down a little, maybe to the level of -3, we'll see. And I think now these images are much more comparable in the terms of color. Actually, this one has quite strong, so maybe 1 point could be added over here, but I wouldn't go that much, because then I actually change the hair color. So there's many different aspects that stop you from it. And I believe for the highlights used over here, we'll have yellows as an opposite for the highlights, and the cyan as an opposite to magenta instead of green, because we don't actually, the green color, I don't like when the image get into this green tones, very unpleasant. So let's go to highlights. On the same, and as you can see, this would be too green, and also I don't want to go into green tones, because the image turned actually too green. So I would rather go with cyans and stick with similar value to the other image. It still doesn't have the amount of lights for the highlights, so we could actually work with this, improving some of the cyans. But it would be maybe not that necessary. I just add 1 point more for the cyans to get it more into cold tones than this image. So it's still a little different in tones, mostly in terms of the highlights, because we have slightly different highlights on each image, but we are getting there. And in the next lesson, I'm going to show you something cool, because I will try to build this paper raw rough look.